Welcome back. When you can count Sir Elton John among your fans, you know you must be doing something right. And the band called Hertz certainly are. They were the best-selling debut act across the world in 2010 with their first album, Happiness.
Since then, the pair has returned to its roots to work on the second album, Exile, and has just completed a 12-date European tour.
Well, they'll be with us in just a moment. First, here's a reminder of one of their biggest hits, Stay. We say goodbye in the pouring rain, and I break down as you walk away.
Stay, stay. 'Cause all my life I felt this way, but I could never find the words to say.
So there you are. Morning, guys. Theo and Adam, who are Hertz, are with us now. There you are in Iceland. You could have gone up into the moors and filmed it up there, couldn't you?
Yeah, painted all the floor black. Painted all the moors black. Yeah.
So you had your friend Elton on there, as you refer to him.
He's on the new album.
He's on the new album.
Our friend Elton, yeah.
How does that work when your friend Elton comes and plays on your album? How do you make that connection?
Oh, we asked him, and he... very nicely said, yeah.
Is he on speed dial or what?
No, we found out a few years ago that he was a fan, and that meant the world to us, and we sort of remembered, and it was on a song called Help, which has also got a choir made of fans from around the world, which we assembled.
So you get in touch with Elton, Sir Elton, and then he comes along to your studio in Manchester.
Popped along, yeah.
Presumably you've sent him the notes beforehand for him to practice a little bit. And then were you just say, here's a piano, Elton, just get playing?
Yes, or kind of, yeah. But he was lovely, you know. He was really complimentary about our music and very sort of positive about new music in general, which was, you know, really good of him.
We just stood behind the glass and just watched with our faces against it like that, just mesmerised. It's honestly, we've gone on the greatest days of our lives.
Did he offer you any advice? Just about the industry or anything?
Do you know what? He was more inspiring that he's got that great passion for music, and like Adam was saying, he's got a great energy for things still, and that's why he is a legend.
We talk more about football.
Yeah,
he's a big football fan.
But there you are, you've been successful around the world, and you've travelled around the world, been lots of places. You could have had the pick of any recording studio you wanted, and yet you came back to your roots. Is it because, and you've admitted you have to be miserable to be creative, is that right? Is it because you can be more miserable here than anywhere else, or what?
Do you know, Manchester's a place that we learned to do what we do, it's where we met, and it's a place that's very inspiring for us. And after going around to Siberia and Indonesia and all these places, we felt it was a nice thing to go to the Curry Mile in Manchester and be relaxed.
But you were very disciplined, I understand.
We were.
When you wrote this, which... I don't know how, when you hear of musicians, you know, creative talents coming out with marvellous ideas, to do it in a regimented environment seems to be a bit of a contradiction.
We've always sort of operated that way, really. 7-day weeks. We challenge each other to see who could go to bed later than the other one. Yeah, every day we made sure we worked hard. Just because, you know, you don't get many opportunities, and, you know, when you do get one, you need to make the most of it.
Well, we've seen the music, reminding ourselves of the music from the first album. Let's have a listen to you something from the next album. This is called Blind. Since the day I left you, I hear your voice in every sound. Since the day I left you, I see your face in every crowd. It won't go away, but every time I feel you near, I close my eyes and turn to see. So that's we're honoured to have that as the premier performance, and an Oscar-winning premier performance from you. What's the storyline there?
It is about a couple who steal Cupid's arrows to fall in love with each other, and then inevitably fall out of love.
Quite melancholy, some of your music. Yeah. What drives that?
It's hard to tell, you know. Music just comes out as it is. And we're not necessarily sort of overly mournful people. It just, when we sit at a piano, it's that we're drawn towards that kind of
music.
It's
like therapy for us, music. Mm. Once we've written the songs, then we feel sort of cleansed. Now we feel good.
But it's also very, your music is sort of very anthemic, and it's every track is a big number. Mm. I'm just thinking, don't you occasionally think, let's just do a little acoustic number, just to quieten things down? Because you think, I've got to make a big production out of every song, haven't you?
It's drama.
Yeah, we like drama.
It's sort of Wagnerian in a way, isn't it?
We like the sort of... It came from our passion for it when we were sort of... In Manchester, we sort of didn't have a record deal, and we just made these pieces of music that we felt were sort of bigger and grand and melodramatic and... That's what music should be for us, I think. It's important to have
it travels well, doesn't it? Because you've toured all over.
Yeah.
And the reception, has obviously been fantastic to this. Is there any way you think it travels better than others?
Everywhere, to be honest. All over Eastern Europe's incredible for us. We have amazing times there.
Yeah. We seem to end up in a lot of places where not many other Western bands go. So we did a great tour of Russia where we went to 6 or 7 places, and most of them where no band outside of
Eurovision
Russia.
Eurovision Song Contest next year. Has to be.
We could be.
Guys, thanks very much.
I think that was a fantastic no. Thanks very much.
Their second album, Hurt, is out now. It's called Exile.
We'll be back tomorrow. Bill, you'll be back with
Louise
from 6 o'clock. I'll see you soon.
Hope you can join us from 6 o'clock tomorrow. See you then. Bye-bye.